Hello learners, welcome back to my channel Shraddha's Physics. In this lecture we will see the interplanar distance of the lattice planes. Before going to the topic, let me tell you once again, what are lattices? The lattices are the imaginary points that are arranged in the space in a regular and periodic manner. We can say that this lattice may be, in some books it is written as, these lattices may be considered as atoms or molecules. Okay. They may be considered as atoms or molecules or ions, etc. So here this is just a periodical arrangement in a regular manner. And the, what is lattice plane? If I join this line, or you can say that in case of the Miller indices and the Miller planes, we have already discussed that part. So here just these are considered, these are supposed the two lattice planes. Okay. Now, if I want to calculate the distance between these two planes, or let me draw like this, if these are two lattice planes, and if I want to calculate the space, the interplanar space between these two planes, then you will use the concept of interplanar distance of the lattice plane. Now, we will see how to calculate this. Let us consider a simple unit cell in which the coordinate axes are orthogonal. Orthogonal means the all axes are the three axes. Suppose here we are considering in the three dimensional system, all the three axes are mutually perpendicular to each other. That is, in case of cubic structure or tetragonal structure and the orthorhombic structure, this alpha, beta, gamma, all the angles are equal to 90 degree. That is, x and y, the angle between x and y equal to angle between y and z, and equal to the angle between z and x, that is equal to 90 degree. That is, as in the Cartesian coordinate system, this is also true for the cubic structure, tetragonal structure and the orthorhombic structure. Now we will use this Cartesian coordinate system to calculate the interplanar spacing. Now let us consider, suppose this one is x axis, this one is y axis and this is my z axis. This OX, OY and OZ are orthogonal axes and the origin is O. It is taken as at any lattice point. This origin is suppose at any lattice point. Now we consider any set of crystal planes defined by the Miller indices, that is HKL. In case of the Miller indices, how we calculate the Miller indices? Let me just tell you. We have to first take the intercept, suppose A, B, C. These are the intercepts, that is along the x-axis it has traveled a distance, along the y-axis the lattice point is at distance b, and the z-axis it is at distance suppose c, and we have to take the reciprocal of this 1 by a, 1 by b and 1 by c. Then we have to take the LCM of this denominator, that is suppose abc, and then I have to multiply this abc in the both 1 by a, 1 by b and 1 by c. So here I am multiplying ABC with the 1 by A, and here again ABC divided by B, and also for the third coordinate this will be ABC by C. So here the Miller indices will be like, suppose this AA get cancelled, this will be BC, and this will be BB get cancelled, this will be AC, and this will be CC get cancelled, this is AB. Actually this ABC, these are the integers, so do not get confused with the AB. Okay. So this BC, AC, AB, this is simply H, K, L, and these are known as the Miller indices. I have already discussed it briefly in the previous videos, that is Miller indices. So just go through that video. So here are the, these are the Miller indices, that is H, K, L. Now this H, K, L also can be defined as the Miller planes. Let the reference plane passes through the origin and the next plane cuts the intercept. OA equal to A by H, OB equal to B by K, OC equal to C by L on X, Y, Z axis respectively. Here we can see that we have considered lattice point is at O. Now if I will consider any plane, it will cross at the point OA, OB and OC. And then if I will join these three, then you can see that here is a plane. Now if we want to calculate the intercept at this OX, OY, OZ point, you know this HKL, these are the Miller planes, and these are the just the reciprocal of the intercept, that is ABC. Now, if ABC are the lattice parameter means the side of the unit cell. This is along the x-axis, along the y-axis is B, along the z-axis is C. Okay, these are the lattice parameter, and we have just taken the reciprocal of this ABC, and we get this HKL as the Miller planes. Now, if I want to calculate the OA distance, OB distance and this OC distance, now simply we have to take A by S, this distance is A by H, this distance is B by K, and this will be C by L. So here, the next plane cuts the intercept as A by H, B by K and C by L on X, Y, Z axis respectively. Now a normal ON is drawn to the plane ABC from the origin. Now you can see that here, this is your normal, is drawn to the plane. So the length d of this normal from the origin to the plane will be the distance between the adjacent planes. Since it is a three-dimensional structure, so you have to just imagine, if you will draw a normal to this plane, that is, this is your plane, okay, to the plane OABC, that is ABC plane, then this ON will give the interplanar distance of the lattice planes, and that ON distance is D. Now we have to find an expression for the D in terms of ABC and HKL, because D is the normal to the plane ABC. This normal distance is D. So let me clear it. So this normal distance is your D. This is your O and this is your N. So this distance is D. Now if I join this line, this is my normal, this vector is normal, ON is normal. Now this is somehow just like this ON. Let me draw it again. This one is perpendicular to this axis. This one is A, this is N, and this is, okay. This angle is, let us consider this angle is alpha. In this ONA, here I am just drawing this triangle here. So in this ONA triangle, you can see this angle is alpha. So from this expression, you can write cos alpha equal to B by H. So B is here. So B equal to this ON, because the angle adjacent to it is ON side, divided by this OA. This is the hypotenuse. So here we can write this cos alpha equal to ON divided by OA. Similarly, in case of, similarly, you can see that this is my normal. Now if I'll draw this line, I'm joining this line, this is N, here is O, and this one is B. So in this triangle ONB, this is perpendicular. In this angle, this one is perpendicular, and the angle between ON and OB is beta, suppose. So now I can write the cos beta, this will be equal to ON, this is ON divided by OB. And similarly, if I will write for the cos gamma, so here you can see this is my normal, and here I am also joining this line, that is NC, this is N, here is O. So here this is the normal, and if I will consider this angle is gamma, so in the triangle ONC, this is ONC, in triangle ONC, cos gamma will be equal to ON divided by, this one is OC, so ON by OC. So here cos beta equal to ON by OB and cos gamma equal to ON by OC. Here alpha equal to the angle NOA and beta is NOB angle and gamma is NOC angle. Now from the direction of cosine, the law of direction cosine says that cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma, this is equal to 1. Now in place of cos square alpha, if I put cos alpha is ON by OA, so this is ON by OA whole square plus cos beta is ON by OB, So this is simply ON by OB whole square, and cos gamma equal to ON by OC. This is ON by OC whole square, that is equal to 1. And in the diagram, you know the normal ON equal to D. Now you can see here, this ON distance, this ON length, this is D. And the OA, here let me write it here. You know the cos alpha equal to ON by OA. So the value of ON is D divided by this OA is A by H. This is your A by H. So simply this will be D divided by A by H. Similarly, cos beta equal to ON means this is D divided by OB is here B by K. So this will be simply B by K. And similarly, cos gamma will be equal to ON is D divided by, here is C by L. So this will be D divided by C by L. Now, let us see. This ON by OA whole square is D by A by H whole square plus ON means D divided by OB is B by H whole square plus ON means D divided by OC is C by H whole square. That is equal to 1. And if I will take common D square, then this will be H square by A square plus K square by, sorry, this is K and this is L. Okay, this one is K and this one is L. So this will be D square whole into H square by A square plus this will be K square by B square plus L square by C square, and that is equal to 1. Okay, here we have already calculated cos alpha is D by A by H, cos beta is D by B by K, and cos gamma is D by C by L. Okay. So here simply substituting that value and taking d square common, this will be this much. And again d square will be equal to, d square equal to 1 by h square by a square plus k square by b square plus l square by c square. And if I'll take the square root of both sides, that is if I'll multiply 1 by 2 here in the power and here on the right hand side, if I'll multiply half in the power, then this will be equal to d equal to h square by a square plus k square by b square plus l square by c square whole power minus 1 by 2. Since this is 1 by something, so this will be whole power minus 1 by 2. So this d is nothing but the interplanar spacing. So this relation is applicable to the primitive lattice in cubic, orthorhombic and tetragonal systems. So just remember these things. D will be equal to, d is the interplanar spacing. Okay, d is the interplanar spacing between the two lattice planes. When the three sides are equal, that is a, b, c are equal, that is for the cubic system. If I'll consider first for the cubic system, when a equal to b equal to c, in that case we can write d will be equal to, here d will be equal to a square divided by a square plus this will be k square by a square and plus l square by a square, and if I'll, and whole power minus 1 by 2. And if I'll take common 1 by a square, this will be 1 by a square power minus half. So this 2 get cancelled and this will be a power minus 1. So this is 1 by a power minus 1 is simply a. 1 by a power minus 1 is simply a. So this will be divided by a square plus k square plus l square root of, so this will be divided by a square plus k square plus l square root of. So for the cubic lattice, you can see the interplanar spacing is d equal to a by root over of a square plus k square plus l square, a square plus k square plus l square. Okay, or simply you can directly substitute here. Okay, so this will be d square equal to 1 by this much. You can just do it by yourself. Okay, now we'll see for the tetragonal cube, tetragonal crystal. So this will be a equal to b, only the two sides are equal, that is a equal to b. So in that case, this a square plus b square, here we will write a square by a square plus k square by a square, or we can simply write it as, taking 1 by a square common, this will be a square plus k square divided by a square plus this will be l square plus l square divided by c square whole power minus half. So this is for the tetragonal crystal. And similarly, you can calculate for the orthorhombic crystal. So this is all about your interplanar spacing. This is the general formula, that is d equal to, this d equal to a square by a square प्लस के स्क्वेयर बाई बी स्क्वेयर प्लस एल स्क्वेयर बाई सी स्क्वेयर होल पावर माइनस आर. दिस इज ऑल फॉर टुडे. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट कैन आस्क मी इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. थैंक यू ऑल.